Hi guys. So good to see everybody. All right, while we're waiting, just a couple more minutes. Give me a thumbs up if you had a good break. Do you have a good break? Give me a thumb sideways if you had a okay break. Give me a thumbs down if it was tough. Was it tough to be away from your buddies? I see a lot of thumbs up. If you were thumbs down, that's okay too. Sometimes breaks are tough. Sometimes you just want to be with your friends at school, right? And sometimes a break is great. So, well, I missed you. I missed you last week. So I'm so excited to see you today. And we are right at 2 o'clock. So I'm going to get us started because I know you guys have so many more things to do today. So you are nearing the end of your day, though. So I can imagine that you're a little excited to be finished with school for today. And maybe your energy is a little bit high. So we're going to move a little bit today. But first, I'm going to talk for a little bit. And I'm going to apologize for talking maybe a little bit more than we usually do, but I'm going to try to get you guys moving as soon as I can. But I have to explain some stuff that's really important. So remember how last week, oh, again, if you guys don't remember me or if you haven't tuned in before, I'm Emily. I'm Miss Emily. So it's great to see you. And remember last week we talked, if you were here with me, we talked a little bit about the different types of stress and we talked about comfort zone and stretch zone and our danger zone. And in our comfort zone, we're kind of, if we have any stress, it's positive stress. In our stretch zone, we feel okay. We might be a little nervous about something, but we can do it. And in our danger zone, we're like, whoa, no way, I can't do that no matter what. So those are those feelings of stress in your body. Well, today we're going to talk a little bit more about what happens when you feel stress. So before we do, let's do a quick check-in. So do you guys remember how this goes? So we're gonna do, you can either do a thumbs up if you don't wanna tell me your number, or you can give me a number. So remember, zero fist or zero is I feel good to go. I feel like I can accomplish anything right now. I have the tools I need. I can move forward. Remember, one is I still feel pretty good. Two is I feel okay. I think I still got it. But I'm starting to maybe feel like I might need some tools. Three is I'm a little more in the yellow zone. I might need more tools to help me out, but I'm still okay. Four or five are I feel not okay. All right. I don't feel like I have the tools I need. I don't feel comfortable moving forward. I need to pause. Okay. So you guys ready? Fist to five. How are you feeling? Or you can just give me a thumbs up, thumbs down. How are you feeling? I'm like a fist right now. Let me see. What do you have? All right, you guys, great job. And remember, it's okay wherever you are. If you're here, that's okay. If you're here, that's okay. If you're here, that's okay. It's just where you are right now. All right, awesome job. Okay, so today I said we're going to talk a little bit about more about what happens in your body and your brain when you feel stress. So I have a friend. I have a couple friends. This one you're going to meet first. Can you see him? He is my bulldog. He is my bulldog. He is being very mellow right now. So my bulldog, I'm introducing you to first because he is my protector. He lives in a place in my brain called my amygdala. And it's like kind of tucked in like back here in my brain. So he's kind of hides out in there until he thinks he's needed. And then he'll come out. And what do bulldogs do? Maybe show me with your hands when they get scared or they think they need to protect. They start barking. I love this one. I love the big mouth. Yes. They start barking, right? And he tries to protect me when he thinks I'm in danger. So he lives back here in all of our brains, in your brains too. You guys each have your own bulldog in inside your amygdala. And that's a part of your brain that tells your brain and your body if you need to be saved, if you need help. So let's say maybe you are, since it's almost Halloween, Let's say you are out trick-or-treating, which I hope we get to do this year, and somebody pops out from behind a bush and they scare you. Do you think you're going to be calm, or do you think your bulldog is going to come out? Show me with a thumbs up, thumbs down, or thumbs sideways. Your bulldog is coming out, right? I see a thumbs down. My bulldog would be out. My bulldog would be so freaked out. He would be scared. So he'd come out and he'd start barking. But I notice that it's my friend. Am I in danger? No, I'm not in danger. But my bulldog thought I was in danger. So he came out. So that's my bulldog's job. So if I am really in danger, I want him to come out and I want him to tell me what I need to do immediately. So he's going to tell me to run. He's going to tell me to fight, or he's going to tell me to be really still, right? Or maybe do a few other things. So he protects me. Then we have, I'm going to call this one a her because I called my bulldog a him. But my bulldog could be a her and this could be a him, or they could both be hers or hims. So whatever your bulldog is and your owl is, that's okay. So this is my wise owl. My wise owl lives in this front part of my brain. Do you guys remember this one? Some of you have learned this before. It's called your prefrontal cortex. Prefrontal cortex. So owl lives up here. My owl makes good decisions. She decides how I should act or react, right? But when my bulldog starts barking, what do you think happens to my owl? When there's loud noises, do you think my owl stays and hangs out with the bulldog? Or does she fly away? She flies away. Good job, you guys. Yeah, she flies away. She gets super scared. So then she's my decision maker. She makes the good decisions. She's super wise. Can I make good decisions anymore? Because my owl's gone. No, my owl's gone. Okay, so remember, we sometimes need our bulldog and we sometimes need our owl. But we need to be able to decide which one to use. So that is the idea behind responding, which is what we do with our owl, or reacting, which is what we do with our bulldog. Our bulldog is automatic. He just starts barking. Our owl takes time and thinks. All right, you guys, are you ready to see how much you know after we talked for just a few minutes? And you guys were so patient, thank you. Okay. So teachers, I'm gonna apologize in advance because we might get a little crazy here, but we're gonna try to reel it in, okay? So you guys, if you're feeling really high energy, I want you to try to tell yourself right now, use your owl, tell yourself, I have to be respectful because I'm still in class, but I do wanna give you a chance to move. So I'm also gonna ask you, when I tell you that it's okay to use your voices, and this is with the okay of your teacher, that you're just gonna use a low voice. So like a classroom voice or an inside voice, okay? Instead of an outside voice. So when I read something and you think that it's your bulldog, your bulldog's job or your bulldog's reaction, you get to get in a bulldog stance. So you can decide what that looks like. My bulldog's like tough and he's kind of ready, right? And then you get to quietly, inside voice, bark twice. So woof, woof. Okay, inside voice, if it's okay with your teacher. If you think it is your owl's response or your owl's job when I read it, you are gonna get to flap your wings, and two times you get to say hoo hoo. Okay, all right, but inside voices. And we're gonna do our best to keep our bodies safe, right? Okay, are you ready? Thumbs up or thumbs down? Everybody ready? All right, awesome. Okay, first one. This animal starts overreacting, slamming doors because your mom and dad or dad asked you to clean up your room and you got really angry. Which one? Which one? That's right. Great job, you guys. Great job. Okay, next one. You came inside and you burst into tears because your friend told you they didn't want to play with you. Is that your bulldog or is that your owl? So you Immediately, ooh, I see a lot of owls. Ooh, I think I tricked you guys. Guess which one that was. Switch it over. That's your bulldog. Because you didn't even think about it. You just started crying and you got really upset and you were super sad. So your bulldog doesn't just have to be mad. Your bulldog can get sad too, right? It's just your automatic response, your automatic reaction. Okay, how about you decided that you could, even though you didn't agree with someone, that you could try to understand their perspective and see things from their point of view. Which one would that be? Ooh, you guys are good. Good job. So awesome, you guys. Great job. Okay, next one. You were yelling at your brother or your sister or your cousin because they took something out of your room. That's right. That's right. I see some owls in there. Do you yell when you think about it? That one is your bulldog. Good job. Okay. How about thinking before you speak? Thinking before you speak. Yes. Nice job. Nice job. Okay. One more. How about blaming someone else when something goes wrong or you get into trouble? It's not your fault. Which one is that? Blame someone else. It's your fault I did that. Oh, I see lots of bulldogs. That's right. That's your bulldog. That's your bulldog. So if you thought that was your owl, think about that for a minute. You blame someone else instead of saying, okay, how could I have done that differently? Would that have been a wise owl response? Yes. Awesome. Okay. So if our bulldog, we're going to do a little more moving around here. If our bulldog comes out, but we know we don't need our bulldog, we need our owl, and our owl flew away. She's way over here. Our bulldog's right here on our shoulder, barking away. But we need our owl back. Maybe you came into class and your teacher said, oh, we have a test today, and you totally forgot about it. Your bulldog is probably going to come out because you start getting really nervous and maybe feel a little stress, right? Oh my gosh, I didn't remember. I feel really nervous. I'm not ready. I don't know what I'm going to do. And then your bulldog flies away, but you need her back here because guess where the answers to your tests live? In your wise owl part of your brain. Yes. So how do you get your wise owl back? A lot of you guys are going to remember this. Can you give me a thumbs up if you remember this thing? Yeah, I'm going to move my screen back a little bit so you can see it blow up. Okay, so to get our wise owl back, we need to use our magic breath. And remember, that is your breathing, your breath that goes in and out of your belly. So I'm going to do this with the ball so you know how to breathe. So remember, this one you can breathe in your nose. You can breathe out your mouth if that feels good, or you can just keep it in your nose. And you're, when you breathe in, your belly's gonna grow. Whoa! And when you breathe out, your belly's gonna get small again. Okay, are you ready? We're gonna do five. So can you guys help me count these down? You can use your arms to make the ball, okay? So when you breathe in, you're gonna make the big ball. And when you breathe out, you're gonna fold your ball back in. Okay, ready? Breathe in. Breathe out. Breathe in. Breathe out. Breathe in. Breathe out. Two more. Breathe in. Remember, make your belly big. Breathe out. Breathe in, make your belly really big. And breathe out. All right, so that belly breath, that type of breathing kind of acts like a little leash for our bulldog. It kind of brings him back in and we pat him and we say, it's okay, it's all right. Everything is gonna be fine. We need our owl back for this whatever it is, for our test, for how we respond to our parents when they say something maybe we don't like, or when we react or respond to our friend who maybe said something that didn't feel very good. So let's just remember when we need our bulldog, when we're really in danger, and when we don't. All right? You guys did a great job today. Everybody good? Can you do one more check-in for me? All right, so let's just do a thumbs up check-in. So thumbs up, thumbs middle, thumbs down. How are you feeling now? I love the dancing. Can I see a little dancing? All right, awesome. Dancing with control of your body, right? Because you're still in class. Awesome job, you guys. Okay, I will see you, you know what? If you guys have time and your teacher says it's okay, we have one video that we really, really, really love.
I get really mad when my brother hits me a lot.
I don't like it when you say you don't want to play with me.
When I'm mad, my brain can get a headache and it can start hurting.
Your blood keeps pumping because you're like really mad. And you start to get sweaty because you're getting really, really mad. And then when you start getting really mad, you turn red.
When your body can't really control yourself, mad just takes over your body.
I just get out of control.
It's kind of like if you had a jar and then the jar would be your brain, and then you put glitter in the jar, and that would be how you would feel. Like, if you shook up the jar and the glitter went everywhere, that would be how your mind looks. And it's like spinning around, and then you don't have any time to think.
And you sometimes punch stuff and people when you don't really mean it.
When I get angry, I feel it in my heart.
I really don't like when I get angry.
The amygdala really reacts, but the prefrontal cortex tries to keep it down.
When I like feel like I want to, you know, get really angry and yell, I just like sometimes, you know, like take deep breaths.
Like first you find a place where you can be alone, then you find some way to relax and calm down.
When I need to calm down, I take deep breaths.
I breathe in through my nose.
Sometimes I close my eyes or just take deep breaths.
It like it's calming down, it's like not like moving. It's like slowing down and then it stops. And the heart pumps slow and then it goes into your brain.
It's like all the sparkles are at the bottom of your brain.
My brain like slows down and then like I feel more calm and then I'm like ready to speak to that person.